The vast state of Alaska contains 86 active volcanoes, of which 3 are erupting right now. While many of these volcanoes, such as Mount Redoubt, are well known, others are not. One of these lesser-known volcanoes lied completely undiscovered until 1979. Yet, the volcano in question produced a large eruption nearly identical to the 1980 eruption of Mount Saint Helens approximately 2,800 years ago. The volcano I am referring to is known as Yantarni, which is a fascinating low-prominence volcano. The Yantarni volcano can be found in southwest Alaska on the sparsely populated Alaskan Peninsula, where it is 40 miles or 65 kilometers south of the town of Pilot Point. If I turn off overlays of the volcano, it becomes quite easy to see why it was unknown to science until its discovery in 1979, since it does not greatly stand out in the overall landscape. Also, it is located between 2 larger volcanoes, Aniakchak to the west and Chiganagak to the northeast. In total, this volcano contains a meager 3.5 cubic kilometers of material, a third of which was produced in a single eruption. Its summit consists of a small stratocone which is breached to the east, upon which a 2,500-foot-wide lava dome is present. The Yantarni volcano began forming 460,000 years ago when a volume of basaltic andesite lava erupted onto the surface at the site of a high-angle fault. This fault was the site of prior volcanic activity several million years ago and thus represented a path of least resistance for fresh molten rock. At the time, the glacially carved valleys were already present, so the freshly erupted lava began depositing on the western edge of an already elevated slope. However, since this lava was rather viscous, it did not quickly travel down slope. Rather, it remained there and slowly began building a small volcanic cone. This cone was quickly built due to intermittent ejections of ash which occurred through volcanic explosions, occasionally generating short-distance pyroclastic flows. Over the span of several years, low-level eruptive activity built a 330-foot or 100-meter-tall volcanic cone. Then, the volcano became dormant for 50,000 years. When it erupted again, the lava it produced was slightly more viscous as it contained a higher silica content. Once again, several small-scale eruptions increased the overall height of the volcanic cone, building it to its modern height. Over the next 400,000 years, the record of eruptive activity is unclear. Small-scale effusive eruptions likely continued intermittently, but more importantly, a body of magma underlying the volcano began altering the rocks on its eastern flank, causing the area to change to yellow and white colors. Fumaroles continued deforming the edifice until a critical point was reached. Then, in 800 BC, a new intrusion of magma occurred underneath the east flank of Yantarni. This pushed the ground upwards, forming a prominent bulge. This bulge eventually burst, leading to a massive landslide. As the eastern half of the volcano collapsed, it was funneled at high speeds into the adjacent glacial valley, traveling up to 4 kilometers distant. Pyroclastic flows accelerated at several hundred miles per hour out of this blast, incinerating everything up to 5 miles or 8 kilometers distant. As large amounts of ash were ejected high into the atmosphere, the day seemingly turned to night due to the immense amount of falling material. After this explosive phase ended, a lava dome was built in the site of the new U-shaped collapse scar, forming Yantarni's modern summit. In total, 1 cubic kilometer of volcanic rock was ejected in an eruption which was assigned a volcanic explosivity index of 5. Since then, no additional volcanic activity has occurred. In all likelihood, it will be tens of thousands of years before this volcano erupts again. The vast majority of its eruptions are primarily effusive, resulting in short-distance lava flows. Since no one lives adjacent to the volcano, no structures are in direct danger. However, a less likely explosive eruption could disrupt regional air traffic if it were to erupt again. As a result of these hazards, the U.S. Geological Survey designated Yantarni as a moderate threat volcano. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Titolus for supporting this channel.